Good morning. So today I want to talk a little bit about kind of learning to be an adult, because I find myself a lot of the times asking questions like, well, I never knew that, or when was I supposed to learn that, or how did you figure that out, or what's going on? That's probably the most common one. What is going on? So kind of want to talk about it a little bit because I've kind of heard from different people, different age groups, kind of what goes on, or when they learn things, who they learned them from, and I found it really interesting. So let's start. One of the most common things I hear is that people don't know how to cook. Now this goes across the board, and a lot of the times I hear it for guys as well, which I find ironic because one of the big things that I hear a lot is that women belong in the kitchen, which has been fought a lot, and it's been like a running gag to say that to a woman, see what happens. Typically violence, but you know. And it's funny to me hearing this, and it's one of my husband's favorite things to talk about because almost everything that we've ever heard people say that women are supposed to be doing, you can kind of point out a guy who's doing it professionally. So cooking, male chefs. There's a lot. different things like that. So, but in general, cooking has been one of the things that, I don't know, people just don't seem to know very much about anymore. And I think it's really interesting because it's one of the really, really important skills. And I've heard a lot of different reasons for it. One of them is people say that it's because they don't teach home ec anymore, or it's not required. Because I do remember my high school doing home ec, but I never actually took that class. I was busy taking upper level classes or AP classes and filling my schedule so that in theory I wouldn't have to take as many classes. That never happened, but you know. So those classes aren't as frequently taught anymore, and so because of that, people have forgotten to how to cook, or the basics of cooking, or they have to figure it out, or people, like, not saying names, forget Pop-Tarts in the oven until they're briquettes. I've heard a friend who forgot to put water in a ramen cup. Now, some of these are just things that people forget, but at the same time, when I'm doing something along those lines, I keep an eye on things in the microwave, or I at least stay in the same room as it. If it's a ramen cup, you bet I'm going to be standing right in front of that microwave, like, is it done yet? I'm hungry, is it done yet? But that's just because I love to eat. When I put stuff in the oven, I try to always make sure there's a timer, so if it goes off at some point, I'm like, oh, I put something in the oven. I also like to keep an eye on things in the kitchen. But, and so that got me thinking, that particular one about learning to cook. How did I learn to cook? Because if you don't know me very well, I love to cook. I have always enjoyed cooking. It's just a lot of fun, like throwing things together and seeing how they taste, or figuring out how things are made. And I don't know, it's just a lot of fun for me. And learning new recipes. I'm gonna attempt to do a pot roast today, so I will probably talk about that tomorrow. If I don't talk about it tomorrow, let's just assume it didn't go well. But I just like to cook, and it's always been a thing. And so it started me thinking, how did I learn to cook though? And I remember that when I was young, my mom, and you can ask her today, she doesn't like cooking. She says that she only cooked so that her children would eat. So I do remember that there were things, certain recipes that she made that she didn't put as many things like onions in it, because my two younger sisters don't like onions very much. They've kind of gotten over it, but they still don't like onions very much. One of my sisters doesn't like bell peppers. What else? I think celery might be one of them. I don't know. Either way, we were picky in different ways, but so my mom changed some recipes to make without it, and so she would just kind of cook to feed, so it would be whatever, not necessarily what tastes best, but what was easiest to cook and what everyone was gonna eat. And I remember at some point, and I can't remember exactly if it was she asked me to help her or I wanted to help her, but either way, I was in the kitchen with her and watching her cook, and it was fascinating to me because she didn't measure anything. She just kind of was like, well, I, more or less, I put a thing of this, I put a thing of this, I shake a little bit here. And it's one of the reasons why, if you follow my Facebook page, I like to share that whole, we don't cook by measurements. We just keep shaking, putting more seasoning until the spirits of our ancestors say, that's enough. Because it's funny, because we do cook that way sometimes. And so I remember just kind of watching and like, okay, well, it's always about this much of this and based on this and like figuring it out. And it didn't quite make sense to me at the time how you could just throw stuff together and it tasted good, because there were no measurements and there was no nothing like that would make sure that it was going to be the same every time. And it wasn't, but it was always good. So I remember that. I remember that my mom would like kind of scramble eggs in the morning, usually like frozen hash browns, sausages, whatever we had in the house, and that's what she would make. But I don't remember when I took over, because I do remember at some point that I started volunteering to cook all the time. So I was making breakfasts, and I even took a piece of cardboard folded in half and like wrote on Sharpie on it, and I called it the menu because I thought it was fancy if I put the accent on it. And I wrote down all the things that I knew how to make in the kitchen, and I would put it on there, and I said, you know, if you're hungry, let me know and I'll make you something, because I wanted to practice, but I'm only one person, and if I keep making food, I can't eat it all. And it would go bad, so I would kind of like wait around. And I remember one time I got really discouraged cooking because I tried to make this omelet and threw a bunch of stuff in it because I thought it would be cool, and I tried it and it was disgusting and I hated it. I left it there and I was really mad, and my dad was like, I remember he walked in at some point and was like, why is this just sitting here? And I was like, because it's gross and I messed up and I don't want to do this anymore. And I was like pouting, and he ended up eating and he was like, I don't know what you're talking about, it was really good. And I was like, okay. Which has happened before with my dad, and I think he might just be trying to make me feel better. But that's a different story of how I figured out I can't bake. but that's how I figured out how to cook. It was never taught in a class. It was never, like, something that at some point somebody said that I needed to do. It was just my mom was cooking, and I paid attention. And I know it kind of comes up a lot because my sisters don't have the same fascination with cooking. They cook to eat, and that's about it. So they don't know as much cooking. One of them does bake, and I'm a little mad because she got the baking skills and I didn't. But she does really good at baking. And so she didn't, I don't know if she actually picked it up from any one of us, but I do remember that my mom bought her like a cupcake recipe book. And I have a lot of cooking cookbooks, but I think that had more to do with the fact that my mom liked fancier meals, didn't want to cook them, and I did, so she bought me cookbooks. But that's how we learned to cook, and it wasn't like a specific time that somebody decided that we needed to learn this life skill. And I found out a little bit later that my grandmother, when she was learning to cook, my grandfather actually taught her because she didn't know how to cook. I thought that was really interesting. And then I heard another story from a friend that was her grandmother, I might be wrong, and if it's your story, please correct me. But her grandmother was teaching her daughters to cook, but would only teach them to make one part of the meal, and then would let them go play outside because she wanted them to be kids. Well, this led to when the mom got married, she could only make one thing at a time. So she would make one thing, put it aside, make one thing, put it aside. So it took her, like, depending how many sides they were, like 3 times, 4 times as long to cook. And by the time she was done, the first thing was cold. And this is just the only way she knew how to cook. She was only ever cooking one thing at a time and not, like, putting a whole meal together. If you watch me cook, I have, like, every burner going that's on. Yesterday I had 2 burners going. I had the oven on, and I had something else going on that I can't remember anymore. I might have been prepping, but, like, I have the whole kitchen. And I've told my husband before, I was like, you need to let me know if you're the kitchen, because I'm like twirling and whirling and knocking stuff over, and I have a knife in my hand sometimes. I'm careful, but if I don't know you're in the room, things can happen. Hasn't happened yet, and I'm glad. But I told him, if you let me know, I'll put this down, it's fine. Because I remember I did bump into him a lot the first time I cooked with him there, because he wanted help. I'm not used to having help. But anyway, so there's just all of these things that, for cooking, different things that people learned and how they learned it. More recently, I've noticed that not a lot of people know how to cook. They're kind of, there's all of these studies and everything that it's like people don't know how to boil an egg, people don't know how to, like, what was it, fry an egg, boil pasta. I love the man and I appreciate the effort, but my husband, one of the times when we were dating, I'd stay really late at work because it was the end of the year, we were trying to finish some reports, and I needed to stay late. So I texted him, like, probably like 8 o'clock, and I was like, look, I'm still at work. I usually get off at 5, and I was like, I'm still at work. I don't think I'm going to be able to cook dinner tonight. And I'd been cooking every time we would come over to each other's place. And I was like, I'm not going to be able to cook dinner tonight. I'm really sorry. I'm probably just going to home and crash. And he was like, well, if you want, I can make you dinner. Love the man. He got a frozen bag of pasta and just threw it in a skillet, defrosted it, put it in a Tupperware and brought it over my place. I wish it was good, but it wasn't. At least not to me. I didn't like it, but I appreciated the effort. Fortunately, he did make something he's really good at, which is mashed potatoes, and I just was like shoveling mashed potatoes into my mouth because that was the one thing there. I was like, okay, I can eat this, and I'm really hungry anyway. He also made a pasta salad that he really likes with all of his particular ingredients. And he was explaining it to my mom, because my mom just thought I was being picky. And I was like, no, tell her what's in this pasta salad. And he, like, broke it down. And she was, after, like, she was like, okay, I'm following. After the last couple of ingredients, she was like, why? That doesn't sound good anymore. And I was like, I'm not picky. It's just differences in, I guess, flavors, what he likes. He likes olives and I don't. So that was one of the ingredients. But anyway, he knows how to cook some very basic stuff, and he will defrost a lot of stuff, and when he makes stuff, it's usually grilling meats, potatoes. He'll make me spaghetti sometimes when I'm being really lazy, because if you don't know, spaghetti is my favorite food. Anyway, there's all of these different techniques, and it's interesting to me how we all learn these skills, because cooking is one of those valuable life skills that if you do not learn, you can starve to death, and that'll be the end of that. So why isn't it important enough to make it like a requirement? Like somewhere along the way, like, I don't know, your senior year in high school, somebody asks you, have you learned to cook yet? No? Cooking classes, home ec, something, or make it a requirement again, and you can test out of it or something. But we seem to have waxed in certain things that we need. Cooking is just one really big example for me because it's something I love doing, and it kind of shocks me sometimes when people don't know how to cook. And I'm not talking like you don't have to make a 5-star meal. Like, spaghetti is good enough for me, or like frying an egg. But hearing that people don't know how to do that really baffles me sometimes. And so that's one of the big examples that I'm very passionate about. Some of the other examples are when, and it's all over Facebook, mostly just because that's where a lot of millennials and Gen Z are all the time, and so that's where we communicate with each other. But there's things like, I don't know how to do taxes, but the mitochondria is a powerhouse of the cell. I don't know, just reminded me of something else, but I don't know if that will ever be useful to me, per se, because I don't have a degree in sciences, and I don't foresee myself ever pursuing a career in science, but I know that fact. I know a few other facts that aren't always very useful to me about, like, the construction of a cell, which I appreciate my science teacher doing it so well that I still remember, but I don't ever remember a class on how to pay your taxes and how to do your taxes. And I think it was the first year I had to do my taxes on my own. I was at home, and a friend of mine, her mom does taxes, and she helped me out, and I appreciate that woman so much. She really helped me out. And then the next time, I was in San Antonio, and I was freaking out because I'd never done my taxes on my own before, and I wasn't really going to be able to drive back to have my friend's mom help me out again. And so I was really panicked, but my now husband, where we were dating, engaged, I don't know, it might have been dating. Either way, his dad is a realtor, so he has to do like the 1099 forms and everything, so they always buy a version of the tax prep software. And I think it, I don't know if it was his turn to buy it or their turn to buy it. Either way, they all do theirs kind of on their own, but with the same program. And he took mine and put it in and helped me out. And many reasons I love this man. And I was joking around, like, the whole beginning of that, like, figuring out this stuff on my own, that my dad stopped taking care of me, so I found someone who would. And it makes me laugh, and I think it... I'd like to think it makes him laugh, but I'm sure it also makes him mad. But, you know, it happens. But I don't remember it ever being a class in school how to do taxes. And to this day, I mean, I kind of understand how they work. You make a certain amount of money, and it gets withdrawn from your check and put aside, and at the end of the year, not even, like, calendar year, like a fiscal year. If I'm using the wrong terminology, please comment and correct me. I'm learning. You get essentially charged, like, okay, this is how much taxes you owe. And then all of the money that you saved up gets paid towards that. If you have more than that, yeah. If you have more than that saved up kind of thing, that's what you get back. That's your refund. If you have less than that, you have to pay more. And that's usually, like, if you're a business and things like that. Or 1099. So there's all of these things that I'm still kind of learning the basics of, but I don't think I was ever sat down and said, okay, we're going to teach taxes now. And that's another life skill of just living here in the U.S. where you pay your taxes. And part of my brain is like, what if I just don't do them because I don't know, like, they already have my money, right? No, you can get in trouble and you get fined and you have to pay more money. And so it's just all of these things. It's actually really important, but there's not a class on this. I learned how to balance a checkbook, but not in school. My mom pulled us aside, and when we started doing piggy bank savings accounts when we were young, every time we went and deposited money into the bank, she would take us. We'd go in one at a time. I'm sure the teller was very happy to see us every time because there's three of us. We would go up. We'd give the money. They'd, like, give us a little stamp on our card and, like, a receipt on how much it was, and my mom would say, hold on to it. We'd get home. We'd all sit down. She'd, like, pull out the little, like, I don't know what it's called, like a transaction thing. It's a grid. It just, you write all the stuff down, and it has, like, what you're supposed to be writing down. And she'd be like, okay, we're going to fill it out. And we'd fill it out, and we'd put where the stuff, where it goes. She'd be like, so how much do you have? And we would say it, and we'd check the receipts, and that's how much we had in our account. That's more or less how to balance a checkbook. I don't actually do it now, but that's partly because I'm constantly swiping through my banking app, just being like, yep, that's me, that's me, that's me. Wait. Yeah, that was me. Granted, now I also have to go and be like, that wasn't me. Check who it was. That was my husband, not me. And just keep going, and life changes, right? But my point to all of this, when were we supposed to learn these skills? Is it something that your parents are supposed to teach you? And if that's the case, what happens to the kids that are in things like foster care? The kids who don't have present parents, kids that have parents that are really, really busy, like single parents. They do their best, but they also have to make money to pay for this kid. And they're busy and they're tired. And it's not something that everybody thinks about because sometimes we think of it as common sense. And so what are we doing to help all of these kids who will eventually become adults? I think my parents did a really good job because for the most part I've managed to figure a lot of this out. And what I haven't figured out, I know people who can help me out. My husband, every time, like, I come up with something, what was it? There was a light that was out on our street. It was blinking red. Which, if you don't know, that essentially means to treat it like a stop sign. But I was driving through it, and I don't even remember how it came up. I think I was talking to him hands-free calling. And I was like, what would you do? Like, I'm sure you have to tell somebody if a light is out, because, like, imagine if it's, like, one of those roads that's not really used very often and the light goes out. Who do you tell? Like, I'm sure there's somebody that you're supposed to report it to. Like, if something, I don't know, fell on our house, like, the light came off or something, like, they'd come knock on our door and be like, hey, your light fell off, and that would be that. Or we'd see it and we'd take care of it. But if you don't see it, how are they supposed to take care of it? And so it's like things like that that I don't know if you ever think about. He told me that here you're supposed to call a 311 number. But there's like a whole list of things that we need to be teaching our kids. Whether they are our kids, they're mentored, they're our students, they're our cousins, nieces, nephews, like, we need to start making sure and having our checklist of all of the life skills that we use and make sure that they know these. Because the last thing you want is kids that don't know how to cook and don't know how to feed themselves, which can lead to them being very unhealthy and eating fast food all the time and gaining a lot of weight, which isn't a bad thing unless it's very unhealthy weight. And the food that we eat sets us up for how we feel, how we do, and our health. Kids that don't know how to do taxes end up not knowing and maybe accruing fines, maybe not knowing what they're doing, or paying more than they need to, and all of this litany of stuff. All of these things are life skills that everybody should have and should be taught to them, whether it's by their parents, their teachers, their mentors. It doesn't matter who, it matters that it's done. Because at the end of the day, they need to grow up, be their own adults, and maybe have kids of their own someday. And in order to get there, there's all of these things that you need to be able to do just to survive. So the next time you're in a situation where you're helping teach, or you're meeting, or you're deciding to have kids, or your kids are getting old enough to teach these things, remember how important it is for you to know it and make sure that they do. Thanks for listening.